So next is the account list report. After the account submasters, where we are dealing with all the drop downs relevant to the customer master, which we saw, I will see the account list report and see what is the details available in this. The account list report will list you all the accounts that are created in the software and all the customers, vendors. We'll see the vendor creation after this and come back to this report and verify the details. But all the details of the contact will be displayed here. Their address, shipping address, mobile number. See, we have created Rajputana and Enterprises. All the details are available here. Everything. In this, we have three report type options. All the reports will have a standard layout where there will be an option for report type. Then you'll have a show button, options button relevant to that report. Date range, again, you can either click this and define a date range for what you're looking at, or you can just drop down, just filter the dates quickly, this week, this month or something. So anyways, there's an option for bulk update here. Either you click bulk update and you can directly update all the HSN code or the GST numbers quickly. This would be for products. Now if you want to update all the areas to be different name, you just select the area, new value, saying Borivali or the other. And once you click proceed, all the contacts area is automatically getting updated. So likewise, you can update multiple values. You can filter a particular set of records of a particular group and then bulk update. Or you can filter all the fans of Mumbai together and then change their subgroup or categorize their zone to something like outstation clients or Mumbai clients. And then finally click update. So once you click update, all the ones which are ticked here will get updated. If you don't want to update a particular contact, you can remove the ticks. And see, this is moreover applicable only for customers and supplier accounts. So we do not need all this other information here. You can go to options. All the reports will find this options button where you have multiple filter options. Since this account, this report is related to the accounts, this account related sub options have come here. The submasters where you can filter multiple groups. Let's say I just select Netas and maybe a customer accounts also. I've selected these two. I can even filter multiple parameters here. Each of this parameter I can have multiple values. And once I click apply, all the filters with all the parameters with all the multiple values will get filtered and the report will be generated. So now with this parameter, only this contact is available. I can click edit here and I can start updating the address here also. I can type the address 2 here, it will get updated. Let's say 5th floor, ground floor, shop number 2. I can update the phone numbers, everything here, and finally I can click update. See, as and when you change any value here, the tick will come automatically. And once you click update, likewise I can update multiple contacts if I have in the same sheet itself, like an Excel sheet. And for all, the ticks will come automatically for the rows wherever you're updating. And wherever there's a tick, once you click this update, those rows, the values will get updated in the masters. Now to verify whether it has been updated or not, you can just double click here. And you can see the shop number 2 and the ground floor has come in the billing address. Same way, we'll just create one more customer saying, let's say, I'm not filling any other information, it's all optional. Once I click save, invalid state. So state is a compulsory thing. Let's say Tamil Nadu. And I click save. GST number has not been fed in, but it's not been marked as a mandatory thing set up there. Now Ashok Opticals, if you see, the code has automatically come as C1002. So alias is also getting generated. Now once I click show here again, and find me, you can find two customers. See, one is grouped under customer accounts, other is grouped under sundry datas. So by default, all gets created under sundry datas only. What is sundry datas? The account group which we are talking about. This one. Okay. Now if I want to create a new group under customers, saying dealers, like sundry datas and customers, if I want to create one more group, how do I do that? I go to masters, go to account submasters, go to account groups. I create a new name saying, let's say, dealers. And it is asking for a parent group. So dealers I want under sundry datas. So I can just select sundry creditors or sundry datas. All these heads are available here. Under which one do you want this? Do you want the address details for that? Do you want the trading related information like GST number and all that? If both are required, then you can take this and you can save. Now let's say I go to account, this Ashok Opticals. I click edit here. I can change a group to like dealers. A new option is coming. Basically internally it is under sundry datas only. having the same impact on the balance sheet, but in the balance sheet it will show it separately. Sundry debtors will come separately, dealers will come separately, their balances. Now I have saved it under dealers. Once you click show, in this report itself I can find out why that name has gone. Because we have filled, we have not selected dealers here. Understood? So dealers option have also started coming here now. So all the dealers will be grouped separately, all the customers will be grouped separately. In the same report, if we have SMS module, we can send bulk SMS, we can go ahead with bulk envelope printing also. We can filter out particular subgroups like corporates and friends, only those contacts will be listed. Those we can extract to Excel or send bulk SMS, do bulk emailing. We even have an option, multiple report type here, update credit days and credit limit. If I just click show here, for all these contacts I can quickly update credit days and credit limit. Rather than going one by one like an Excel sheet, I can just click edit and bulk update here itself for all the contacts one by one in a single row. Same way address book. Address book is nothing but we have an option where we can see by default it shows the phone number, mobile number, fax number for quick contact. There are multiple options here. Again, you want to print it normal or you want to print envelopes for it or you want to print A4 size label for it. Once you click this, I have to select the contacts first. If I give print A4 labels, it will get me a preview in a 16, I mean default layout of A4 sheet where there are 16 labels available, 2 in a row. So Ashok Opticals, there's Rajkumar Enterprises, there are 3 addresses, 1 billing address, 2 shipping address, so all 3 have come here. Ashok Opticals, we did not mention the address, so that has not come. These are the remaining labels which we can take print out, we can peel off and stick on the invitations. Same way, there is other option of printing basic details. Once you click this basic details, it will print the basic information of each contact in a Ashok Optical, city, phone number, email ID for a quick thing. Print phone numbers only or export all the report to Excel. See, all the reports, wherever you see any preview, once you click print, you will get a preview like this for all the contacts. I'll come back to this. Update GST number details. Now since GST has come, we have even one more option where you can quickly update the GST numbers. And we have last option saying unused accounts. There's one more important report where you can click unused account, click show. It will show you all the contacts which are not used anywhere. And then you can select all and delete, bulk delete. So if you have imported contacts from an Excel sheet or from old software and you have contacts from years which you have brought in now, either you can select them one by one, whichever are not required, and delete them from here in one shot. Or you can just open this unused contact report, find all the contacts which are not related anywhere in the software. Those can be deleted immediately. So you can just select them and click delete. Okay. So this is the use of account list report, where you can find out all the contacts, do bulk update, editing, you can find out unused contacts, delete them, and you can take address label printing, phone number, contact printing, diary printing kind of thing. And you can even print envelope. If you have SMS module activated, you can select the contacts and send bulk SMS. Filter it as per the multiple parameters for subgroup or group or area, city, pin. If you want all the contacts of Mumbai, you just select city Mumbai and click apply. You get all the contacts of Mumbai only that you can extract in Excel also, and then do whatever action required. Next we will go to vendors. As we have seen the customers, the same thing is applicable for vendor. We'll just create one of the vendor names saying, let's say Suresh Traders. Or we'll give something else. So Deepak Traders. See, all the information are same. Regional name, again we'll come back to this. This might more will be required for customers, not for vendors, because vendors we are already creating in. One more thing there, which is there in this regional languages. By default the name is coming in Hindi. I give them whatever you selected last time, this will remain stored. So every time you need not select this language again. Last time I selected Hindi, so it came in Hindi. When, as and when I type, no, there's even an option available here. Once I press the space, it is showing me which option do you want. So I can select Deepak. So now it has taken both Hindi and Tamil together. So Deepak one word is okay for me. Then we go with the next word. As I press enter, it is showing me which one is correct. Traders. Now generally the first one should be correct. And this is getting appended here, you can proceed. That is showing me Deepak Traders.
So you have Deepak traders. Traders can be
phonetically
changed. Meaning can be
changed. No. Either it will be both, or it will be phonetic, or it will be. See, if there's no meaning for Deepak word in Tamil, means it won't understand. It will bring in English itself. So generally, this phonetic translation is only required. This meaning translation is rarely being asked. Rest of the contact information, where the vendor also can have multiple billing shipping addresses. Same way, key contacts, who is the purchase in charge there, or who is the marketing manager there, who is the CEO there, you can create the contacts. Same way, that GST number details, TIN numbers become obsolete. Whether they are providing us with rate plus tax or net rate. Other details, who has referred us the vendor, from which data we incorporated with the vendor. The credit days that he is providing us, the credit limit that he is providing us. And beyond this credit days or credit limit, we are not supposed to place orders. So we'll get alerts that we, this vendor, while making the next order, it will alert that you need to make the payment for the earlier one. So system will alert us, we'll make the payment, so that vendor will not stop our process, or then there won't be any interruptions in the business execution. Same way, any salesperson, the agent one, who has referred us to this vendor, someone who is there in between for bringing all this. There are many textile stores where there are agents in between. Customers or the store owners are directly not knowing any vendor directly, and these agents are having good contacts with different vendors across different states like Surat, Kolkata, and they know which good quality product is available with which vendors. So this agent will come in the south region here, and they will market saying they can provide the best deals from best vendors. Instead of the owner going to different places finding the correct vendor, and again, trust is also a concept. So this agents will help us in finding the best vendor, getting the deal, and they will be there in between for good supply as well as for making the payments. Since the vendors are not known, a direct big order placement or making the payments becomes difficult. So who is the agent name in between who has led us to contact to this Deepak Traders can also be mentioned here. And if he is having any commission also, that also can be mentioned here, because while making the purchase also there are chances where the agent will ask a commission, 1%, 2%. So you will get the discounts for us and you will get the best deal, so that we have lesser cost itself. Then same way, vendor bank details and their settings, whether we are dealing maintained bill to bill wise or stop transactions and all this. We have not defined any alias code for vendors, so alias code will not get defined automatically, and we will just click save. Again, invalid states, let's say Deepak is from Tamil Nadu only. I'll create one more from other state, let's say Srivaru. And I just mentioned status Karnataka. I'm not mentioning any address details here. Again, if you define it, it's much better, but it's all same. Next to vendors, we'll see the general ledger. What is general ledger? Vendors are suppliers, okay? Customers, suppliers. General ledger is all about anything other than customers and vendors. The business will have a lot of other things. It's not only customers, vendors. You have your bank accounts, you have your rental accounts, you have electricity expenses, so many different expenses. You have your own capital invested in the business, and there are partners in certain business, so partners capital account also would be there. If it's a proprietorship, it's a direct capital account.
Can you explain
anything other than customers and vendors will fall into general ledger. So customers will get created as a part of sales. Vendors is a part of purchase. So someone with a user who is having rights to purchases, he will get the access to the vendor screen also, where he can create new vendors and directly enter the purchase. He is not depending on anything, or he is not having any task to do with the general ledger or customers. Whereas someone who is handling accounts, he has to pay the expenses, he has to ensure that capital account and all these balance sheets are being taken care of. So there, he might be dealing with all these three customers, vendors and general ledger. Someone who is into sales, he will have access only to create new customers. He is not dealing, or he is not even seeing any of the supplier. Who is the supplier, he won't get that access. We can limit that access. So the screen is split and all three are same. All three are called as our accounts only. Under the part of accounts, these are the ledger heads. All three are ledger heads only, but we have segregated them. One is for customers, second is for suppliers, and third is for general ledgers. General ledgers will have everything. You can find so many account group here. You have bank accounts, bank overdraft account, balance, division, cash in hand, current assets, liabilities, loans taken, loans given, expenses, indirect, fixed assets that we have in the businesses, incomes indirect. This all heads are even available in Tally and any other accounting software. These are general accounting heads available across the world. And based on this only, we'll be segregating this new contacts among this. For example, let's say we have an account called ICICI Bank. So under general ledger, we'll be creating this. The ICICI Bank is not a customer, neither a vendor. So this is a separate category which is coming in. And ICICI Bank, we are just grouping them under bank account. So why this grouping is required? So based on this grouping, system will understand what treatment should be given to it. So it's a bank account now. So this we can access it while recipient payments. As well as we can even link this account for mode of payment swiping. For the card swiping at the counter, we can link this ICICI account there. So that when customer swipes the card, we can enter the amount against it. It will automatically start reflecting in our bank account. We'll see the example for this. Bank also, it's in Tamil Nadu now. The state has become compulsory after the GST has come in. And let's say office expenses. So it will come under expenses indirect. Freight charges. This is the only one, generally this is one of the highly used expense account which comes under direct expenses. Rest of the expenses are always termed as indirect expenses. Freight, shipping, all this related to transportation will come under direct expenses. Same way you can have tea coffee expenses separately, your individual staff salary account separately. And whenever there's an advance being paid to the staff, you can mention a payment against that name. Tomorrow when you see a ledger of a particular staff, you can find out all the transaction detail right from the beginning, what was the opening, which all date payment has been made. Okay. So likewise, even the capital account, cash in hand account is automatically there. Bank we have just created, and we have created a couple of expense accounts also. Generally, most of it will just create expenses in this thing only. Capital account will come once. If there's any loan taken, loan provided, loans and advances, assessments, we have provided a loan to someone. And if we have taken loans, then it's a loan liability. If we have taken loan for business purposes, then we'll create that account head saying from XYZ person we have taken a loan. That group will, it will be grouped under loans liability. It will show as payable in the balance sheet. We'll see the balance sheet part separately, but just understand a simple concept here. It's all about defining the proper heads and grouping them under proper accounting group. This part is important here in the screen. If it's a bank account, don't create it as expenses. The treatment will go wrong. If it's a bank, mention in bank. If it's expense, mention in expenses. Only freight will generally comes in the direct expenses, and there are a few others, but rest of the things will come under expenses indirect. There are a few other accounts like trade discount, or all these are coming. Trade discount is something which, I mean, the discounts that we give while billing will be settled off there. Sometimes we get a discount from the supplier that will mark it under trade discount. So that is an income indirect. So that is also already defaultly created. You need not change that. Rest of the information are same here again. You can search anything quickly, you can merge two accounts, you can attach documents. So this is with general ledger. Now whatever vendors, customers that we have created, coming back to account list report, we can find out all this list coming here. So ICICI Bank has come here, cash account is already there, and the liabilities we have reverse charge coming in. This is for GST again. Customer we have one, dealer we have one, direct expenses we have one, indirect expenses we have few. See, these are all, most of them are already created by default in the software. Round off account is created automatically. See, while billing, if there's any 25 paise round off that happens automatically, that will go into this ledger. Stock account, then these two sundry creditors, one from Mumbai and one from Tamil Nadu and one from this Karnataka that we have created. We can again bulk edit here and update all the contacts that are required, or filter only customers and vendors and find out the details. Okay, so we'll proceed with this next. Next we have salesperson by agent. And see, there are four options here. First is for creation of the salesperson. Second, we can create different group for salesperson also. Like certain salesperson are architects, certain are interiors. Certain might be carpenters. We can group them separately. So salesperson can be external also or internal also. Within the team also, you can group them as separate salesperson, maybe for section For sarees as a separate salesperson, for readymades as a separate salesperson, for materials as a separate salesperson. You can group them in a separate thing. And there's an address report for salesperson also. We can generate all the contacts address together and send them some gifts during Diwali, or you can just courier them something or put them a card. So salesperson will create a couple of salesperson. Let's say Prem, we can just mention a salesperson alias also, or salesperson alias can also be auto-generated if required. This mobile number can be mentioned here, this door number, address details. We are not feeding in all this, but I am just guiding you through it once. If you want, you can feed one, at least we will see an example. Let's say Prem, birthday anniversary reminders can also come in. We can link an account with the salesperson. What is the usage of linking an account? Is a salary account or is incentive account? We can just create one ledger saying general ledger saying Prem's salary account or Prem's commission account, which will be under expenses indirect, and we can link that account here just for an association that the salesperson is having an account linked with us. It will show you separate incentive reports for it. The salesperson can be for sales only or for purchase only. See, if it's a purchase related agent also, is a salesperson for internally. If it's linked with purchase, you'll select it for purchases only. Generally, if it's a salesperson for the counter within the premises or an agent, someone who has got us some customers, then it will be for sales only. This name will be listed for your selection purpose while in purchase entry screen and in sales entry. If it's for all means, this name will be listed for sales in the sales screen also as well as in the purchase screen also. Let's say for sales only. And his commission, if there's any fixed commission for him, you can mention it here. Otherwise, you can directly save. You can even link an image for him, the salesperson image, and we save it. Let's say we create one more command. I don't feed any information, I just select for, let's say, for purchase. Maybe one for sale. Purchases, I'll create one more thing. Likewise, you can create n number of salesperson. You can create their groups, and the group or the grouping option will come after that in the salesperson screen. Unless the groups are not created, it won't show you that grouping option in the salesperson master. Once you see the salesperson address report, you'll find all the details here. Default is an admin salesperson, there's a direct salesperson. Suresh is created. Remaining these three have been created in a group called none. For sales only or for purchase only, you can see the details. You click show full details, will give you all the information about salesperson, the address details, along with the image. Everything is blank here, so you can, as per the data, it will display all this. Next in the masters, we'll go with products. Now, what all is available in product? Default product will have the screen. The GST section has come here, where you have HSN code and GST tax class here. We have created all the tax classes so that are being displayed here. Apart from this, there's one more tax option available here. This is for VAT. This has become obsolete now and it's no more in use, this VAT and commodity code in India after GST. Before GST, this was being used, this option was not available. Now, after GST, this has become obsolete. Only this tax and this commodity code. Rest of the information is all same. So we'll start with the product master. Let's say we create a couple of products saying let's say Parker pen. Product code, if we have an auto generated product alias, then even this product code will come automatically. And where do we set this up? We'll even set that and we'll see. So we'll see the product master setup first and come back to this. In product master setup, there are a few other options where enable expiry, enable manufacturing, enable regional name. All these options will come here. We'll see all these options separately in the detail session for a products separately. For currently, we can have this option where we can set up the mandatory fields for the products. After mandatory fields, we have an option for different product types. We'll learn this product types in a separate session. Then we have few other options where we want to enable screen setup. Basically, if you enable certain options here, you'll find new options on the screen coming in. You want some weight description. If you give yes, it will give you one more column on the screen saying weight description. Type the weight description. Enable MRP will enable an MRP option coming in the rates. So one more new column for MRP will come on the screen. Generally, all businesses are not requiring this, so by default it's no. But when for certain business, if it's required, you mark it yes here and it will start applying on the screen. So validations, we have few other validations here. If this will have an impact on the billing, if the rate is less than sales rate, what it should do. If for product, if we define 100 rupees in the master as the sales rate, and in billing if we type it 95, it will show alert. It should allow or block or product wise. Same way, rate less than cost rate, what should it do? Allow, alert, block or account product wise, you select this. Same way, rate different than the last supply rate. Basically, in this bill I have given 100, and the next bill I am giving at lesser value, 99. Then the rate is different than the last one. Should it show alert, allow, block or product wise? Rate more than MRP. Generally, you are not supposed to sell more than MRP. If you have defined an MRP here which is not updated, let's say an old MRP is there for 5 rupees and today the MRP has become 7 rupees. If you are selling at 7 rupees, MRP is not updated in our master list, and if you are selling more than MRP, what should you do? This is for one this case. Other cases, even though if the MRP is 7 rupees and you are trying to sell at 8 rupees, it's legally not allowed. Whatever is the MRP, you are not supposed to sell more than that. So by default, it should allow alert or block what should happen. And negative stock billing is also product wise available. Whether for the product wise, if it's negative stock, what it should do? Allow alert block. Okay, coming back to this default decimal values. See, we have a decimal option on the screen behind. If your products are dealing with zero decimal, basically rounded values. If it's all pieces, 10 pence means there's no decimal. But if you see with something with weight, if you're selling fruits and vegetables, then it might be 4.5 kgs. In that scenario, you might require 0.00. If it's something more in liquid or some jewelry means, it might even require 0.00, where 10.645 grams. Then you might require this decimal. So default decimals you can define. Product code, prefix and suffix. Let's say all my products should start with P and suffix should be nothing. Seed can be starting from number 1 or let's say 1001. I want to start from 1000. Length is 4. I can save this. So these are the default settings available here. There are few many settings. We will have a separate session going in detail for the product master, but this is sufficient for now. Same way, we can even enable the regional language of the products also. And I can save this. So to refresh, I'll have to close the screen and open it again. Coming back to products. Let's say Parker Ink Pen. Product code will get created automatically. Regional language, I'll convert. Tamil, Parker Ink Pen, the name has come in Tamil automatically. Either I can type here and I can do, or let's say here if you want to give 0.5. I'm just giving one thing additional. So it will automatically append this. Also I can give like this. I can click proceed. Okay. Next we have group name where I can define, it can be like pen. Category can be ink pen. And brand can be Parker. Unit will be pieces. No decimals. There can be a commission percentage for each product for the salesperson. So for this product there might be 1%, or some other product which is on higher rate, maybe 4%. So product wise we can define different percentages and we can generate incentive report for the salesperson. So salesperson will also try pushing which products are having more commission, he will try pushing those products first. Date of incorporation, from which date are we dealing in this? Add to dashboard, again there's a dashboard report available in which we will always have the current stock of this product in front of us as well as turnover in front of us. Stop transactions, as like customer master we have stop transaction where we are stopping to deal with this product further. Sometimes it so happens the government has banned the product and we still have the stock but mistakenly it should not get sold. So we will stop transaction here itself, no one will be used, I mean able to use it in the billing, and unless it is billed in, it will not be delivered to the customer. Then we have an HSN code, with GST we have got this code for all the product. Irrelevant of the name, HSN code is the one which is required for the government to find out what commodity is selling more in which state. Overall India, how much pens are being stored, being sold, they'll understand that with this HSN code. They are not bothered about what name we are defining, but as per the code it should be correct. And total state wise they'll be able to find out what, how many pens are being sold. Just a minute. So we'll have an HSN code like it will be from 2 digits to 8 digits. Let's say we just give 1111 as a HSN code. And what is the tax percentage applicable? So we have all these taxes that we have defined in the GST setup. These taxes are coming in 5%. If you have any other technical description for the product or some specification that you want to specifically mention in the printout also or while the searching purpose also, those options will be listed here. I mean, this remarks will be displayed on the screen. So let's say I can give something like something general. So if it's about some machinery and all, they can have some specification saying this is the length, this is the width, or if it's about medicines, you can have some like store in cold place or keep it in a dry place. This is obsolete. Then we can have a purchaser, let's say I'm buying at 10 rupees, let's say 10 pen, I'm buying at 25 rupees, my landing cost is also 25 rupees. What is the difference between purchase rate and landing cost? Landing cost can even be additional because while after the transport it might be some additional charges incurred on, we have out of the pocket we will incur additional expenses on unloading, loading or transportation. So that might be something like 26 or 27 if required. Sales rate, let's say I want to sell at 30 rupees. Any fixed discount if I am giving on this product, then I can define the fixed discount here. Second is the special or the scheme discount that we have defined. And then third you can define the maximum discount. Maximum discount if you define 10, then by mistaken also user will not be able to give 15%, it will get restricted to 10. See, it's required because sometimes mistakenly if the additional discount is given, we might incur losses. Let's say this is for 25 rupees, we are selling at 30 rupees, and if the user gives 50% discount, then we are selling basically at 15 rupees, which is less than our cost.
Loss.
It's a loss. So that time we can restrict this, where there's a lot of products and people are on counter, the sales people are there and they are billing very fast. Sometimes it's off, chances where they miss out, instead of 5 they type 50 and they press enter, and without their knowledge it goes into losses. So we can restrict this by defining the maximum discount. Next we have minimum quantity, maximum quantity, reorder quantity and lead time. This is the reorder management system that we have. Minimum quantity is like any point of time I should have 20 pieces of this pen in the stock. Maximum quantity is to avoid overstocking, where I should not have more than 50 pieces in the stock. If it's 50 pieces, means I'm overstocking it. My sales is not that fast also. And reorder quantity is like if it's coming below 20, how much should I reorder again? Let's say once it comes below 20, I should order 20 again. And lead time is nothing but how much time does it take for the goods to be reaching our premises once we place the order. So for this Parker pen, once I place the order, it might take 3 days or 4 days from the vendor to be supplied to my store. So accordingly, I can plan my sales also. So I'll get a report on this. And who is the preferred vendor for the Parker pen? Default preferred vendor. Whenever I am buying a Parker pen, which vendor should I prefer? So by default that name will be coming for raising a purchase order. Let's say I just select Deepak Traders. Again, last option is inactive for the entire product. This is not for the vendor, it's for the product. Like stop transaction inactive, inactive also will stop displaying this product in the search list.
Yes, inactive means inactive for what? Which one?
For the entire product.
So you don't want to purchase it anymore,
like that? It will not be displayed in the search anymore. I have created one pen. Again, I'll create Parker gel pen. So what are other options available? I can link an image with the product. For example, let's say I have to go to edit mode in order to link an image. I can click edit. Let's say I can just have any pen. Here pen. I can get an image from a webcam also. Okay, there's a background services which has stopped here. And it will, if the webcam services are on, it will directly display the webcam and you can directly get, I can get it from a scanner, or I can browse and select an image. And so we'll just select one random image here. I'm just selecting one image here. I'm just saving this with the product. Other options available is, once I save this, I'll save the image here. I'll make a copy of this product to create a product again. So in the options, I have an option saying attach documents. We can attach some technical specification. I can see the closing stock. I can copy this product. I can see the product history, where all, which all transaction has been used. Batch list is nothing but, we'll understand the batch concept of the product later. We can maintain product batch wise or barcode wise. Each product will have its own purchase date. There will be a unique number coming with each product. We will see the batch list, but we can open all that batch list report, batch link with this product in a separate report separately. And we have an option to update price list also. If there are multiple price lists for this product, instead of going to each price list, you can click the price list update here. It will show you all the prices like corporate, government, hospitals, whatever you have created. And you can update the rates for each price list for this product here itself in the same screen. So right now I am just giving copy product. I click yes. So it's saying Parker pen copy. So to quickly create one more product, I'll just keep Parker gel pen. I'll remove this. I can again change this also. Parker gel pen and proceed. Now this time it's, instead of ink, it is a gel. What is the use of this group, category and brand? Let's say HSN code for this is 2222 and 5%. Let's say 40 rupees. I'm not filling any of this information. So what is the use of this group, category and brand is? You can always find out group wise sales, group wise stock left. Category ink. Ink wise I might have Parker pen, Reynolds pen, I might have XYZ pen. So n number of different brands ink pen. If I want to find total ink pens I have in stock, it will show all the ink pens together. As a category I can see the stocks. Same way as with the group I can see the stock. Brand also I can see the sales and stock. Everywhere you can find sales, stock, profits, everything on this, all this combination. If I want to find out total Parker, how much am I selling, irrespective of whatever the product, I can find out brand wise sales, Parker, total sales, total profit, total stock left, everything. Let us create one more book, let's say classmate 100 pages. So I can just give books. I can even have group saying stationery, something that I can have category book. The detail level, however you define those combination of reports you'll get. So 100 pages books can be categorized into a separate category together. Or you can even categorize as school book or homework book or max book or something. Brand you can give classmate. Pieces again. Let's say HSN code 3333 and this can be a 12% product. And if I'm not defining any rates here, it's not compulsory. So I can fill the rates while the purchase transactions. I'm just saving this without any other details. Likewise, we create all the products here. We can link that image, we can copy the product quickly if it's a similar product, and likewise, we can create all the products. Next two products, you find product submasters, which will have again option for creating product groups here itself, or renaming a group, or renaming a category, merging two brands, mistakenly the spelling mistake in two brands, and while reporting you'll find separately, Parker separately, Parkers separately. We can merge the brand, you can see the reports together. Same way packing unit, commodity code is obsolete, HSN code we can create here in the masters itself separately. Other than creating each option here, you can create in the masters here. The user can just select. There are two other options here, batch, category and process master. This we'll learn later, this is not very important here. This is specific to certain businesses. Batch category we'll understand once we go with the batch concept. Next we have a report called product list, where you can just click show and find out all the details of all the products group wise. Now you have this different products. Automatically there's assigned code P1001, 1002 and 1003. And you can directly update the GST. If there's anything wrong with the GST, you can just update the codes here, let's say 18%. You can even update the HSN code here. Same way you can just change the group, category, brand also. Everything can be updated. See, as I have changed one of the value, the tick has come automatically. And finally, whatever are ticked, once I click update, those will get updated. All the information about the product is displayed here. And just click update. And one entry has been updated. Same way there are two other options saying unused product. When we, once we give unused product, it shows that all these three are unused. You can select all and delete them quickly. Many of times it so happens that last financial year data, last year designs of saris are no more applicable now and out of trend. But the product has been created, last year it was purchased, and now this financial year it is no more in purchase. We have split the data also. After the data split, it will no more be connecting to the last year transaction. It will create two different books. That time we can give the unused product and we can select and delete those. Just a minute. There's one more option here saying price list, the third option. This price is nothing but basically a rate list. All the product rates will be displayed here. Purchase rate, landing cost, sales rate, discount 1, discount 2, maximum discount. Something which is relevant to the transactions. And you can go with bulk edit and start changing the rates here. If there's a bulk changes of rate which has come, you can change the rates here itself and you can directly click update. Okay. Unused complete list will give you the details of the product without the rates. Unused products will give you all the products which are not used anywhere. You can delete quickly in bulk or individually, you can select and delete. Price list is basically, this is rate list. We'll just change this caption to rate list, it will be easy. And rate list will show you all the products along with their rates which we can update in bulk and save them. There are certain exception type also available here. When you come to rate list, all products or where cost is zero, only those you want to update, or purchase rate is zero that you want to update, or sales rate is zero or MRP is zero, or where cost rate is less than purchase rate, those products you want to update. In what case cost rate can be less than purchase rate? Purchase rate is 100 rupees and you got 5% discount, then cost is 95. So if you just want to check which all products are like that, you can just do that. Sales rate less than purchase rate. Then you can filter those products quickly and find out if you are going into losses or something. If the staff has done some mistake, and find out those product masters where sales rate is less than purchase rate. Sales rate less than cost rate, sales rate more than MRP. So even more than MRP is also wrong. So either you update the MRP or you update the sales rate accordingly. Here again you can again filter into multiple groups. So you want only to update for books, then you can just select group books and you can proceed and apply. Only those will be listed. So this group filtering options is very important, where you can quickly find out a particular HSN code only you want to update, or a particular GST class only you want to check. All these parameters for grouping, each of them can have multiple values and everything will get applied in the filter. You select all these multiple rows. So this is with the product list report. We have an option here to print the data or export it to Excel. Bulk update you've already seen. There's a new option saying export as template. What is the purpose of export as template? We have a template through which it's like an Excel sheet only. Export as template is an Excel sheet format. We have an Excel sheet format through which we can import the data in software. Any of the client using any other software, we get the data in Excel format and paste it in our max format, product name, product code, product group kind of column wise. And then in one click, we can import all the data and get them started quickly, rather than they creating all the products. Certain clients will have thousands of products. Creating all these products again is a tedious task. So they will tell us to migrate the existing data. So we ask them to get, I mean, any other software will be able to get all this product list in an Excel sheet. From that Excel, we will paste in the R max columnar format of Excel template, and it will be imported in one shot. We'll have a separate session on data import from Excel. But then we have given this option here also as export as template. Why? Tomorrow, if we have one company here and we have one more book or one more business in nearby, anywhere as a branch also, but with a separate TIN number. It's not branch connected to us, but separate entity of the same concern dealing with the same set of products. See, now there's a client, one of the clients having a branch in Chennai, he's having a branch in Mumbai and Delhi also. Product is the same, Chennai is the head office, and Mumbai is a separate entity, but dealing with same set of products, they are given as a franchisee. So whatever products they launch newly, they will update here in the head office, Chennai, and then they'll export as template. It will create one Excel file, they'll email it to them, Mumbai. Mumbai people need not update all the products again or create new price list or start typing them new products. Again, spelling mistakes will be there or some rates mistakes, chances are there. So whatever the Chennai guys doing, they are updating it correctly. And one time effort, they'll export as template, mail it to Mumbai guys. Mumbai guys will select that as a data import template, select that Excel sheet and directly import. While importing, it will ask whether you want to update the existing amount or you want to just add the new ones only. Ignore the duplicate ones. We'll see that part. It's coming in the file import, data import. Once after the Excel template is exported as template, you'll get this option here as Product Master Upload Template. It will automatically download the template with all the products. On the other branches, they'll just have to upload and give ignore duplicates or something. So only the new ones will get added with all the information. We'll see that in detail later, but for now with product list, this is thing. So clear the product master and product list. How to copy a product and all is clear, right? Next we have price list. Again, this price list, there will be a separate session taken where we'll be understanding in detail of how to create a price list, how to link it to a customer, and then how do we use that in billing. I'll not take this now. Next we'll go with taxation. There are three options available here: Excise Master, GST Master, and Taxation. First, both have become obsolete. This was for VAT, and Excise was in India before GST. So there were percentages for Excise also to be defined. These are different taxes which have been taken while on the transaction. Now, with GST Master, it is showing you all the GST taxes available. So we have right from A is 0%, tax class 0, it is showing applicable from this date. Everything is 0 here: 0% purchase, 0% sales, and IGST also. It's all 0%. B, we have 3%, which is splitted into 1.5, 1.5, and IGST is 3. Now, in future, there are any tax changes in GST, we can just append a new row here saying from 1/4/2018, this 3 has become 5 or 4. Then we can just append a new row here and make the required tax changes. For existing products, wherever 3 was linked, from 1/4 onwards, it will become 4%. Likewise, you can even introduce a new tax class also. F is 14, G is, okay, now G is not there. G, you can introduce a new tax class, let's say some 30% or 25% or maybe 20%. And we can split as 10%, 10% for local, and IGST it will be 20%. Likewise, we can apply the new taxes. So any amendments to that existing taxation will be done in the tax master screen. Either it's a amendment in an existing class or changes, or we are adding a new class. New class will start with a new class name. You can just create a new class here and you can start typing the values here. Anyways, we are not dealing with this now, but this is the screen where all the tax changes will happen. Currencies, if your business is dealing with multiple currencies, you can define all the currencies here. By default, this is the current currency, rupees, which we have created while setting up the book. If the multiple currencies module is enabled, then you'll have an option to create new more connection currencies. Like if you're dealing with someone in Dubai, Qatar, their currencies, or someone in US, means you can bill the customer in USD. Those options will get enabled when multiple currencies are there. Closing stock, it will come as a part of balance sheet where you can define a date and you can define a stock value. See, by default, the stock value is whatever stock we have in the business, that is the stock value that will get reflected in the balance sheet. But sometimes it so happens that the rates fluctuations are there. The stock we purchased at 100 rupees, today it might be at 200 rupees, and the stock value, stock somewhere will be showing more high, whereas the actual stock value is less. So if we want the actual stock value to be physically obtained, or we have to calculate and update that in the balance sheet, even for the balance sheet adjustments this is being used, then we can define a date here. This is the closing stock, not the opening stock. Opening stock will come in the accounts opening balances. We are dealing with the closing stock. So closing stock will, here it will show you, I mean, you can mention a date like 31/3/2017, the current March, and whatever value according to you was the stock valuation, then you can mention as 1 lakh, 5 lakh, 10 lakh, whatever it is. So this value will come into picture while we see the balance sheet. In balance sheet, we have an option whether do you want to see the manual stock valuation in the picture, or you want an automated stock value which should come. Automated stock values, as per the purchase sale and whatever is the stock left, that value will come. And manual stock value, when we tick, this value will be picked up for the stock. See, while generating your profits, balance sheet will have this opening stock, closing stock, total stock left, total purchases made. Closing stock will be picked up from this if this you have an option to pick the closing stock value from here instead of system taking from the stock summary. And finally, stock summary has everything. It will show you number of pieces left with each product, its rate, cost rate, and the value. And then it will generate the overall valuation. But more than that, if you want something manually done, then this closing stock will come into picture. And other masters have something called narration list. What is narration list? While receipt and payment, we have some fixed set of narration list like cash withdrawn, brokerage, freight, tea, coffee expenses, petrol charges. Fixed set of narrations which we enter along with the expenses during receipts and payments. This narrations will be displayed by default. So if you want some more default values, you can add here. So this also will be listed in the drop down while doing a receipt payment. Where it will come, once you go to this accounts and receipt payments, let's say you're making a payment, you have this in the drop down on the narration. Those predefined values will come here, so that you don't have to type every time for quick searching purposes. Next, you have terms and condition. As we saw with the customer master, you can define different terms and condition. Let's say 100% this can be one of the term. Let's say 50%. These terms are being printed on the purchase orders, quotations, bill printouts, wherever this term coming in. You can choose the terms for each customer, you can choose a term for a particular bill format, for a quotation you can have a different set of terms. Either it can be customer wise, or it can be voucher wise, or it can be directly dynamically selected with each of the transaction. So you can define n number of terms like no returns, no exchange. And you can link them in the billing. N number of terms can be defined, you can link them in the billing. Okay. Delivery charges extra kind of thing. This reason is for cancellation purpose. Whenever there's a transaction being cancelled, what is the reason? You can predefine the reason, saying the goods been damaged, or it's not been, customer rejected it, or whatever it is. You can define different reasons here. Same way, there are a few other options here. Not very much used, but this is one of the important ones, modes of payment. Mode of payment is what? While in POS screen, you accept cash, you accept card, sometimes you accept gift vouchers, coupons, and membership cards also. But here, mode of payment is specifically for your credit cards. Cash is already linked, it is created when we create the book and is linked with the POS by default. Card is not created because we have just created an ICICI bank account. So let's say I just create a card payment, saying a mode of payment for credit card. Payment type, I have multiple options here where I can choose whether it's cash, cash on delivery, check, coupon, credit note, or something. So I will just select card here, and I will link an account saying ICICI Bank. This is when whatever is being entered in card, that should reflect in the ICICI Bank account. There are two other options here. Service charge. For every card payment, if the bank is charging us 2%, you can select 2% here. Automatically, 2% will get deducted and will get added to the bank charges account. And the balance only will get reflected in ICC. If it's 100 rupees and 2% gone, means 98 rupees will come in the ICC bank account. A few other options here at the bottom is, if the customer name is mandatory. Whenever you take a card, if you want compulsory customer name, then you take this. Without customer name, it won't accept the payment in card. If you mention any amount in card, customer name is compulsory to be entered. Same way, bank name required is not required. Document number is something like last four digits of credit card number. For any card payment, if you want your business or your sales people to follow at least to enter last four digits of credit card, then you give this document number compulsory. Then without this last four digits, it won't accept the payment. Now for membership card, there are two other things. If you are making payment by card, whether points should be calculated or not, and whether points are applicable on card payment or not. Certain businesses are not following this. They say if there is a card payment, already 2% is getting deducted from the bank. Another, if we give more points to the customer also, they will claim against the point later on. So if that linking is not required, you can take this off. I'm just saying this. Where will it impact? If you go to your sales and even in sales invoice, there are three modes of payment here. I mean, three bill type, cash, credit and others. Once you give others, you will get a payment details option at the bottom. In payment details, you'll find cash, credit and credit card. If this credit card was not enabled, means you will have only two options coming. Same in the POS point of sale screen also. After you scan all the customer goods, at the end it will ask you this pop-up where it will show you cash and card. See, this sales invoice screen gets this credit by default, but the POS screen will not get credit default unless we configure it. Because by default on a retail counter, credit is not allowed. You pay and leave. Carry the goods, pay and carry. So what all we have learned today, we'll just quickly summarize. Yesterday we went off with customers, we went in detail of the customers. Then we have learned vendors are the suppliers from whom we buy the goods. Then anything apart from customers and vendors is coming into general ledger, where we create our bank account, we create our expenses account, we create our direct expenses, indirect expenses, capital account is there, partner capital account is there, loans and advances, asset, loans, liability, which we have taken, fixed assets can also be created here. So likewise, all the other accounting heads are available in the general ledger. Account submasters is for all the drop downs, any valuation, value change, any spelling mistakes that you can rectify or you can merge. Account list report will give you a list of all the accounts that you have created. There you can again quickly update all these contacts. You can take a printout, you can export it to Excel, you can do bulk envelope printing, send bulk SMS, filter multiple groups based on subgroup or account group or maybe city area, whatever parameter you have, and accordingly generate the contacts. You can even go with unused accounts and delete them quickly. Next, you can create salesperson, different salesperson either for sales or for purchase, and either group them also separately and see their address report also. Then we went into products, we created a couple of products in different group category and brands, defining the reorder values, minimum quantity, maximum quantity, the default discount percentages we have defined, default preferred vendor we have defined, the particular HSN code and tax, GST tax percentage we have classified properly. Same product submasters will have the options to rename the groups or to merge the groups and delete the ones which are not useful. You can even create the HSN codes here and then directly use in the product master. There is a setting available by which we can stop the dynamic creation of the product subgroups. Basically, if the group is already created, then only you can choose. You cannot type a new group while creating a product master. We have a setting to stop that. Why? Because chances of spelling mistakes or duplications or unnecessary new group creation is there. If we want to restrict our business to choose only those set of brands, those set of categories, then we can stop that as a setting in the book settings and create all the groups here and then only use it in the product master. Product list report, we saw all the product lists are being, all the product with the details are being displayed. You can again see the unused products there. You can bulk edit like an Excel sheet and update the product details. There's even a rate list option where the third price list option, which you get all the products along with their cost and sales rate. Again, bulk update options available where you can update the cost, sales rate, discount percentages together. Prices we will see later. Taxation, you just understood how to see different tax classes. You can even delete an existing tax class which is not in use and create it later. Or an existing tax class, you can change the tax percentages from a particular date. So before that date, the old prior taxes will be applicable. After that date, new taxation will be applicable. currencies is used for defining different currencies that we are dealing with. We are dealing with someone in US, we can create a currency for dollars and use them in billing. And closing stock is for the balance sheet purposes, where we can define a manual closing stock value for a particular date, and that stock value will get impacted in balance sheet, and accordingly our net profits will be adjusted. And at the masters, we saw a narration list where these are being used for reception payments. Terms and conditions which are created here can be used in the customer master for predefining. Plus, we can use it for particular transaction. For quotation, we can define a predefined set of terms. For orders, we can define a preset of terms, like send goods in 7 days, kind of thing. Reason is for your cancellation purposes. Mode of payment is specifically for your credit card setup. So any retail counter, whenever we are setting up things, mode of payment has to be compulsory done right in the beginning itself. So this is with the session 2, and we'll see next set of things in session 3. We'll stop here. Thank you.